in our nation's 243-year history, there has never been a stronger push for mail-in ballots to determine a national election.
Yeah.
Are you considering at any point issuing an executive order addressing mail-in ballots, and why do you think some people are pushing it so hard?
Well, there's never been a push like this for mail-in ballots, and if you look at the New York congressional race, which is a disaster, Carolyn, it's been a total disaster. They have, they're 6 weeks into it now. They have no clue what's going on. And I mean, I think I can say right here and now, I think you have to rerun that race because it's a mess. Nobody knows what's happening with the ballots and the lost ballots and the fraudulent ballots, I guess. I think you probably have to take the Carolyn Maloney race and run it over again. How can you do this? And this is a small race with literally thousands of people, small thousands, and it's all messed up. You look at Paterson, New Jersey, it's all messed up. Almost every one of these, and these are small, easy to control. They should be able to do this easy. Now you're talking about like Nevada, where last two nights ago, they went out and in the darkness of night without people, without having any meetings of the public, without having anything, they approved a ridiculous. You don't have to look at signatures. You don't have to approve anything. You can have double mailings. You can have all sorts of things. Nobody's ever seen anything like it. It's a disgrace. I mean, honestly, it's a disgrace. So it's a very good question. I mean, the mail-in ballots, if you look at just some of the small places, the small races, a congressional race in New York, should be very easy. Normally, that would have been announced at 7 o'clock, and it would have been down to the wire, and everybody would have loved it. If it was at all complex, it would have taken an extra 45 minutes or an hour. They would have announced it a little bit later. They have no clue. This was about 6 weeks ago, and they have no clue what's going on. They've lost ballots. There's fraudulent ballots. It's how are you going to do that for an entire nation? They're using COVID to try and get the mail-in ballots. Now, absentee ballots are great. Absentee ballots, they have to request them. They go through a process. They get them. But the universal mail-in ballots have turned out to be a disaster. And what Nevada has been doing, if you look over the last few days, you have to look at what they've done. You can have two ballots. You can harvest. It's harvesting. So you can take thousands of ballots, put them together, and just dump them down on somebody's desk after a certain period of time. They have something where if you vote, the vote can count up to 7 days later. Well, if the vote's going to count 7 days later, that means you know, if it depends on the one state like Nevada, that would mean simply that you can't have, supposing it's down to that one state, it could be, it's a great state, but supposing it's down to that one state, that means you have to wait 7 days. But they won't have it there. This is something that's so messed up. And by the way, I have to say, the post office for many, many years has been, you know, run in a fashion that hasn't been great. Great workers and everything, but they have old equipment, very old equipment. And I don't think the post office is prepared for a thing like this. You have to ask the people at the post office. But how can the post office be expected to handle? They have regular mailing. And then now on top of that, they have the internet, where you have Amazon and these companies doing, you know, all the buying. Instead of going to a department store, they go buy through mail. So you have massive numbers of purchases now going through the post office, purchases of items and gifts. And that's a tremendous strain on the post office. The post office loses a fortune. It has been for many, many years, for decades. So now on top of it, it has this. And the Amazons of the world and the others, they pay very, very little money. They lose money on every, the post office loses money, which is ridiculous, on every package it delivers. But now on top of that, and I'm not just referring to Amazon, I'm talking about all of the competitors, if there is such a thing to Amazon. There will be, but if there is such a thing. But now on top of that, you'll have somebody like the governor of Nevada come out with this massive plan out of nowhere to take millions of ballots and send them all over the place. You'll never know who won that state. It'll get messed up just like New York and just like Paterson, New Jersey, and just like many other places. In West Virginia, they indicted a postman for doing something very bad. You know that. But there are many cases all over the country. If you look, you'll be able to find. There's a list of them all over the country. And that has to do with universal mail-in. Again, absentee is great. It works. Like in Florida, they'll do absentee. It really works. But universal mail-in ballots is going to be a great embarrassment to our country. Well, I have the right to do it. We haven't gotten there yet, but we'll see what happens. We will be suing in Nevada, and that's already been taken care of. We'll probably file something tomorrow. I do want to say that we're going to be introducing a tremendous health care plan sometime prior, hopefully prior to the end of the month. It's just about completed now. In addition, next month, we'll be doing the immigration plan. So we'll be doing that in September. We'll be doing sometime during this month the health care plan. And I think that'll be before the end of the month. And I think it'll be very impressive to a lot of people. Thank you very much.